Good morning.
Let's graph the instantaneous power delivered by the force of gravity to a pumpkin dropped from a second-story window.
Flippin' physics!
Billy, please read the problem, and Bobby, please translate.
An 8.53-kilogram pumpkin is dropped from a height of 8.91 meters.
Stop, please. Mass equals 8.53 kilograms, and height initial equals 8.91 meters.
Billy?
Will the graph of instantaneous power delivered by the force of gravity as a function of blank be linear? If not, what would you change to make the graph linear? And part A is time, and part B is position.
Okay. Part A, will power as a function of time be linear? Part B, will power as a function of position be linear? And if not, then how?
More specifically, the question refers to the power delivered by the force of gravity, so I have added that subscript. Instantaneous power delivered by the force of gravity equals the force of gravity times the instantaneous velocity times the cosine of the angle theta between those two vectors. We can substitute mass times the acceleration due to gravity for the force of gravity. The force of gravity is down, and the velocity of the pumpkin is down, and the angle theta is then between down and down, which is 0 degrees. The cosine of 0 degrees is 1, so the equation for instantaneous power is mass times the acceleration due to gravity times the instantaneous velocity, which means we need an expression or an equation describing the instantaneous velocity of the pumpkin in terms of, well, for part A, in terms of time. Bo, could you please do that?
Well, the pumpkin is in free fall, so its acceleration is negative little g, or negative 9.81 meters per second squared.
Which means we can use the uniformly accelerated motion equations.
Right. So we're solving for the final velocity, because that's the instantaneous velocity in the power equation. So it's final velocity equals initial velocity plus acceleration times change in time. The pumpkin was dropped, so velocity initial is 0. The acceleration is negative g, and change in time is time final minus time initial. Let's let the initial time be 0, and we get final velocity equals negative g times time final.
That is correct. However, because everything is in the y direction, I'm going to add y subscripts to the appropriate UAM variables. And now we need to substitute this into the equation for instantaneous power. And we get the instantaneous power delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin as a function of time equal to the negative of the mass of the pumpkin times the acceleration due to gravity squared times time final.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bobby?
Don't we use the magnitudes of the force and velocity in the power equation?
Very nice, Bobby. That makes the equation positive. But then will the graph be linear? Billy?
Okay. We know the slope-intercept form of a line is y equals mx plus b.
Actually, let's not use the letter m for slope. We already used the letter m for mass. Let's just use the word slope instead.
Sure. The y value equals slope times the x value plus the y-intercept. Comparing that to the equation power delivered by the force of gravity equals mass times acceleration due to gravity squared times time final... Well, that tells us, well, for one, we know that y-intercept is equal to 0. And if we put power on the y-axis and time on the x-axis, then there is a linear relationship, and the slope of the line is mass times acceleration due to gravity squared. So the answer for part A is yes. Instantaneous power as a function of time will be linear.
Therefore, the slope of the line ends up being 8.53 times 9.81 squared, which is approximately 821 kilograms times meters squared divided by seconds to the fourth power. And the graph looks like this. The instantaneous power starts at 0 watts and increases linearly to a value of roughly 1,100 watts at roughly 1.3 seconds, right before the pumpkin strikes the ground. The rate at which energy is being delivered to the pumpkin by the force of gravity increases linearly as a function of time. On to part B. Bo, what about the power being delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin as a function of position? Is that linear?
Now we need the velocity final of the pumpkin in terms of position, not time. Again, we start with a uniformly accelerated motion equation. Velocity final squared equals velocity initial squared plus 2 times acceleration times displacement. Initial velocity is 0. Acceleration equals negative g. Displacement equals position final minus position initial. Set the initial position equal to 0 and take the square root of the equation to get velocity final equals the square root of negative 2g times position final.
Bo, again, everything is in the y direction. And we can substitute that into the equation for instantaneous power. Power delivered by the force of gravity as a function of y position is equal to mass times the acceleration due to gravity times the square root of negative 2 times acceleration due to gravity times y position final.
Mr. P.
Yes, Bo?
We can't take the square root of a negative number.
And you forgot to use the magnitude of the velocity again.
Interesting. Okay. Bobby, is the square root of negative 2 times acceleration due to gravity times y position final negative? And Bobby, is the square root of a number negative?
The y position final will always be a negative number because the pumpkin is always below the initial position. Therefore, a negative times a negative is positive, so we are not taking the square root of a negative number.
And it's the square root, so we can just use the positive value of the square root to make sure it's the magnitude of the velocity.
Huh. Okay, Billy, will the graph of the power being delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin as a function of position be linear?
Okay, again, we compare to the slope-intercept form of for an equation for a line. Y value equals slope times x value plus y-intercept. Huh, okay, with power on the y-axis, we end up with the square root of position on the x-axis, which means power versus position will not be a linear relationship.
And what should we graph instead to make it a linear relationship?
Let's take the square root of the whole equation. No. Let's take the square of the whole equation to get power squared equals negative 2 times mass squared times acceleration due to gravity cubed times y position final. And that means in order to have a linear relationship, we need power squared on the y-axis and position on the x-axis. The y-intercept is 0, and the slope of the line is negative 2 times mass squared times acceleration due to gravity cubed. Now that's just weird.
Correct. In order to have a linear relationship, we need power delivered by the force of gravity squared on the y-axis and the y position final on the x-axis. And the slope ends up being negative 2 times 8.53 squared times 9.81 cubed, which is roughly negative 137,000 kilograms squared times meters to the fourth power divided by seconds to the sixth power. And the graph looks like this. The instantaneous power squared starts at 0 and increases linearly to a value of roughly 1.2 million watts squared at roughly 9 meters below where the pumpkin started. Notice, if you think in terms of time on this graph, you would move from right to left as the pumpkin falls. As you said, Billy, it is a bit weird, but that is what you need in order to get a linear graph which relates the power delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin as a function of the y position of the pumpkin. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.